We are here at Missouri Wind and Solar in Seymour, Missouri, where we are going to talk about how electric vehicles fit into alternative energy systems. I'm here with Wes, pretty much an expert, at least compared to me, here at this facility. Wes, thanks for having us out today.
Thank you, Mason. I appreciate the high praise.
Yeah, absolutely. Much. So how do electric vehicles fit into these systems?
Yeah, so we do get that question a lot too. Electric vehicles, or we shorthand them as EVs sometimes.
Okay.
So EVs, generally speaking, you can think they take about 75 to 100 kilowatts to charge.
Okay.
And in a traditional environment where you've got power from the grid, that's really not a big deal. You don't have a lot of concerns because you're just the grid's going to provide you whatever you want.
Yeah, it's always there.
It's always there. The only thing you might get into is certain times of the day, it costs you a little bit more than other times of the day. Some places do that sort of type of thing. But the big thing with an alternative energy, and mostly we would be talking about the amount of solar that you would need to charge that, is pretty significant.
Okay.
So if you've been out to our store, we've got a solar tracker out front, and those generate around 15,000 watts or 15 kilowatts.
Okay.
And so if you look at the average production day, which we use 6 hours a day, typically is what the kind of the industry standard we use to figure how long the solar panels can produce their maximum. If you do that math real quick, that's 90 kilowatts. So in a very significant system, you're talking about a whole day's production being centered around charging that car. And so you've got some issues there. One is that you'd have to have the car there during the day.
Okay.
Right? And yeah. So where are most people's cars during the day? They're at work. They're not sitting at their house being charged. And the other is that you would have to have batteries or something to give you the days of autonomy. We talk about days of autonomy where you're not directly using the solar to be able to, you know, power the refrigerator or power the TV, all of those things.
All right, so if somebody does want to invest in solar power and they have an EV, would it be better for them to have a grid-tied system then?
I think the answer to that is it depends. I would talk with one of our salespeople and do the math on what you're looking at, because you don't necessarily have to charge all in one day.
Okay.
That 75 to 100 kilowatt charge gives you, I think they're looking at like a 230 mile range. You know, obviously you don't have to charge it all at one time, so you could charge some, you know, each daily, kind of do trickle charging, that sort of thing. So I would really kind of take a look at that and see. I think it's just something that as technology progresses, we'll see some changes maybe to battery technology that really improves on that sort of thing.
Okay, and like you said, this is a common question that you get, but you guys do have salespeople that will actually answer the phone, so if they call you, they're not gonna get hit with some automated switcher.
Absolutely. So if you wanna know more about this, or we've even had, you know, a lot of conversations even about the different electric vehicles, that sort of thing, we'll be glad to talk with you about that. Just reach out to our sales team. You can reach them at 417-708-5359. You can check out our website, windandsolar.com. We've got a ton of educational tools there. And we offer quarterly workshops where we have folks come in and do a lot of training there too. So we've got a lot of educational materials out there for that. So it's one of the things we really want to focus on is making sure that you've got the tools to make the best decision.
Absolutely.
Particularly in something like this that's relatively speaking, it's pretty new in how people are going to be able to handle it.
All right, perfect. And for those of you at home, if you want more information on any of this, you can always go to this link right here at the bottom of your screen. Wes, as always, thanks for having us out.
Thanks for coming, Mason. I appreciate it.